step pulleys. Now, through a problem, I will be teaching you the use of step pulleys. The headstock of a lathe machine is driven by a counter shaft through a stepped cone pulley, open belt drive. The counter shaft runs at a constant speed of 320 RPM. The three different speeds required at the headstock spindle are 120, 160 and 200 RPM, okay, respectively. The distance between the axes of the counter shaft and the lathe spindle is 720 millimeter, and the radius of the smallest pulley on the counter shaft is 40 mm. Determine the remaining radii of the two stepped pulleys and also the length of the open belt. Also, we will solve the problem in the next for cross belt also. Now here you please see the figure of the step pulley. This is the counter shaft, this is the counter shaft, and this is the step pulley one, and then this is driver shaft. Okay, so this is driver side, this is driven side. So this is a driven shaft and it is in the lathe headstock side, lathe machine headstock side. Now the distance between the axes of this and this is equal to 720. In our finding out the length of the open belt, this L is given 720 mm. Okay, please see my video for the open length of open belt expression. Okay, now here this is the numbering you should remember. 1, this is 1, this is 2, 3, this is 4, 5, this is 6. Okay, now what does it mean? If you give a belt here, then this will be running, and here if you give the belt here, this will be running, same belt, and it will be running. Okay, so length for the open belt, the length of the belt remains constant. Okay, and these are the two cone pulleys. Okay, now these are the data given. Okay, I am not going to explain, you just note down the datas. Okay, now this is the equation, speed ratio N2 by N1 is equal to R1 by R2, that you already know from the simple pulley. So this is given, so this by this, this is given, N2 is given, N1 is given, R1 is given the smallest pulley in the counter shaft, is given R2 to be found out. So R2 can be found out is equal to 106.7 millimeter. Okay, now for the pulley 3 and 4, okay, so this is the equation, same equation with the suffix changes and pulley changes. N4 by N3 is equal to R3 by R4. Okay, so you can get this is this. So here we will get a equation with R3 and R4. The equation is R4 is equal to 2R3. So this is equation number 1. Now length of the belt, now R1, R2 is known, so length of the belt can be found out. This is the equation of the length of the belt, open belt. In open belt, this is minus, okay. So after putting the value, we get the length is 1907 millimeter. Since the length of the belt in an open belt drive for this kind of stepped shaft is constant, so length L for the pulley 3 and 4 is also same, so 1907 is equal to this one, the same equation for the length of the belt. From here, now you see this is a equation for involving R3 and R4. And the previous one, the equation is also this is R4 and R3. One equation and this equation. So this is the two equation. Solving 1 and 2, you can get, solving 1 and 2 equation, we can get R3 and R4 in millimeter. Okay. Now for pulleys 5 and 6. Okay, so this is the equation. This is the equation. So you will get a relation between R5 and R6. Relation between R5 and R6. So similarly, the length of the belt for pulleys 5 and 6 is constant. So this length is this one. So again, this is changing R5, R6. So this is R6 minus R5 by L whole square. This is whole square by L. So, okay. So, this is a equation. Equation number 4. And this is the equation number 3. I have told you. So, 3 and 4, you solve it for R5 and R6. So, solving 3 and 4, we get R5 is equal to 60 mm. R6 is equal to 96 mm. You check it and see the answers. Okay, these are the answers which I have told you. Okay, so all the values of R means radii are found out. Okay, admit. Now for solving the problem in the solve the problem one, if it is a cross belt, so in the so R2 R4 would be same. Okay, this equation is also same. Now this is most important. I will show you what is this. We know that for a cross belt drive, this equation varied. How I will tell you? R1 plus R2 is equal to R3 plus R4 is equal to R5 plus R6. And this is a, this value is R1. R1 value is given and R2 value is given. R1 this and R2 this. So this is equal to this. So this is the equation. Now how this is coming, you will find to prove the crossbend length, the alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 by L. So this is also by L, this is also by L. So L cancels out, okay? So L is the center distance between the shaft, center distance between the first shaft and second shaft, okay? So this is the equation, and you have to remember this equation, that addition of the radius is constant for one pair to another pair, and then the third pair, okay, 5, 6, okay. So this is a equation, so this equation is 2, and one equation, you know this one, so you can solve this equation very easily. So solving 1 and 2, R3 will be equal to this, and R4 will be equal to this, okay. Now equation 3 in the previously remains the same, that is, this equation is same, okay. The in that problem for open belt, this we have shown you. So this, by solving 3 and 2, this means this one and this one, okay. By solving, you try to solve it very easily, you can solve it. R5 is equal to, in terms of R6, and put it here, then you get the value. Take help of this 146.7. So R5 is known and R6 is known for a cross belt, okay? Now I will tell you the use of this belt. You have understood from the problem that in a headstock of a lathe machine, where the driver shaft has having a constant RPM, but you need to get different types of RPM in the headstock, okay. So the belt is you can change the pair of the belt 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and that belt will be running over there, okay. So that is the use of the stepped pulley, okay. Thank you.